From Creamer Media in Johannesburg, I'm David Oliveira. Joining me in studio is Letsego Holdings MD, Chris Lowe, who will be discussing how financial inclusion can reach Africa's low to mid-income populations. Chris, how can financial inclusion be used for economic redress in Africa?
On a number of fronts from where we sit. Letsego has decided to focus on education, on health, on agriculture and affordable housing. All those four areas most people need at some stage in their life, whether they're individuals, families, whether they've got children. So for us, it is about providing simple, appropriate and accessible solutions to the underserved, the unbanked, or those who are financially excluded, with a focus around value add in those areas. That might be a simple loan, it might be a loan with some form of insurance in case they fall sick and lose their earnings, or savings have generally been ignored, so we're looking to find ways to provide mobily accessed savings accounts.
Letsego has a number of digital solutions aimed at promoting financial inclusion. How important and effective are digital solutions at reaching low to mid-income populations?
That's an interesting question. It's not an instant take-up, even though the mobile is ubiquitous. It's part of everyone's dress today. So the way that we are trying to encourage take-up of the use of financial services rather than just pure voice, SMS, etc., is to work with governments to encourage government to persons, G2P or P2G, to support what we're trying to do with some financial literacy, some education around understanding their financial needs, and then starting very simply. So I mentioned micro savings or mobile savings. Most people have a little bit of money, even if it's just during the day, and then the next day they spend it on goods. If we can provide something that secures that, gives them a point of storage, pays them a little bit of interest, they get comfortable with that if they get it back. So you build trust, you build a comfort with using technology over time.
What digital solutions does Letsego have available, and how effective have those been in promoting financial inclusion?
We've got pretty much any channel that you would expect a full-blown commercial bank to have. So internet banking, USSD, the app, we are still in development stage. Most of our target segment at the bottom of the pyramid are still on traditional analog phones, so USSD is important. Clearly we have branches, we've got satellite touch points, and increasingly we're adopting the model that East Africa has been quite successful with third-party agents and with our own agents. So we're doing both owned, partnered and third-party, and that then moves financial services closer to the customer, and that is how we believe that we will further financial inclusion. If you live in a village where the nearest bank is several hundred kilometers away, you're unlikely to be financially included. If your local pharmacy, garage, whatever it might be, is your cash in, cash out point as an agent, then you're going to start to see, well, maybe there's some benefit, as long as the product that we offer gives you that value add. So that's really where we see the next development.
And what's on the horizon for Letsego?
I hope more growth. We've expanded into three new countries in the last 18 months. Tanzania, we did have a presence, but not a banking license, so that gives us savings mobilization capability. We've entered West Africa through Nigeria and Ghana, and we really want to contribute to the economic growth in those countries as well as the rest of our footprint. We're in 11 countries now, so it's a reasonable African footprint.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you very much.
That was Letsego Holdings MD Chris Lowe discussing financial inclusion.